Former Trump National Security Advisor Michael Flynn helped Robert Mueller's investigation so substantially that the special counsel recommended no jail time for lying to federal investigators. But should anybody be concerned in the president's camp or the president himself? And where will the Mueller probe go from here? Are they almost done? Let's ask former assistant U.S. attorney and Fox News contributor Andy McCarthy. Andy, you see the seven pages? Do you see the redactions? What do you make of it?
Well, of course, we can't see what's under the redaction, so we don't know exactly what it is that that General Flynn told the special counsel, or at least how the special counsel interprets it. But I think the part that we're able to see, Brian, is consistent with what I've been arguing for the last number of months and what some other people have observed, which is, number one, we're winding down toward the end of this. You don't let the, as a prosecutor, you don't let the cooperating witnesses get sentenced until you're at the end of the investigation and you can make an appraisal of how cooperative they've been. And secondly, there's a lot in there that indicates that Mueller is trying to justify the FBI's investigation. That is to say, even if they don't find that there was citable criminal conduct on the part of President Trump, they will say that there was adequate reason for the FBI and the Obama administration, very controversially, to launch an investigation of the opposing party's campaign.
So meanwhile, they picked up Flynn by listening to Kislyak, and we're not supposed to know who Flynn's name was. He's an American, but it turns out his name ends up in the Washington Post. Does that bother you?
It bothers me in this sense, Brian. That felony, that is the dissemination of that national security, that classified information to the Washington Post, is by a geometric standard a more serious offense than anything that Flynn did. In fact, it wasn't until I actually, looking at this, I think Flynn, their rationale for prosecuting Flynn is the misstatements about Turkey and the fact that he should have registered with the Justice Department under the FARA provision, the foreign agent provisions. And that wasn't treated as a crime until Mueller came along. Generally, the Justice Department would tell you to get right with the law. They wouldn't make it a felony. But here we have this dissemination of FISA information, which is among the country's most closely held classified information. And as far as who's going to get prosecuted for that, all I'm hearing is crickets so far.
Yeah, and in terms of collusion, speaking to a Russian ambassador is not collusion. Speaking to an Israeli ambassador is not collusion.
Not if you're the...
That's called doing your job.
Right. Yeah, right. If you're the incoming national security advisor, that's kind of what you're supposed to be doing.
Right.
I do think it's kind of surprising to see, maybe not surprising, but Mueller cites the Logan Act, which is this really unconstitutional, two-plus-century-old provision that no one's ever been prosecuted under. He kind of endorses that as a basis for investigating Flynn.
Yeah, we'll see what happens. Well, you do see some indications, like others, that this meeting might be coming to a close. Andy McCarthy, thanks so much.